A intersection B. Which area will be colored? The center, intersecting area. So if this is A intersection B, so we have to color this area on. Now instead of this, if it is given like A intersection B complement, how we are going to shade this? This is A and this is B. Complement, when we are talking about complement, I told you that this box is showing you the universal set. This box is showing you the universal set. Okay? So, A intersection B, I told you that intersection means the common area. So, for the common area, we have to color only this much. Clear? Now, A intersection B complement means we have to leave this A intersection B. We have to come out of this. We are not considering A intersection B. So, we are coming out of this. So, we are going to color it like this. In this way, we are coloring. So, you'll observe that except this center portion, except this center, I am coloring the rest of the part. Now, let us have another example. If I have to color A complement intersection B, A complement intersection B, the set A, the set B. What is A complement? A complement mean any all the things out of this, okay? Out of a whole of the area. For doing this, you must have two different color pencils, okay? So with the help of those pencils, you can do it very easily. I'll give you two methods of doing this. One method is this, that you can use two different colors. Other method, I'll explain after this, okay? So first of all, let me explain you that how we can do this shading with the help of two different colors. For example, first of all, A complement. A complement means out of A. What? Because you can see that this is the circle for A. So out of this circle, the rest of the part will be colored. The rest of the part will be colored, leaving A. Leaving A, we are going to color the rest of the part. This is A complement. This is the rough working which I am going to tell you. Whenever this question comes, you can do this in the rough portion with the help of the lead pencil. Well, so this coloring is done in the rough portion. Now, B, which is set B? This complete circle is for B. What I should do? I should color B with a different, I should shade B with a different color. Like the complete set B, I am coloring the complete set B like this. Are you observing? Here in this section, you can see that both the lines are intersecting. In this portion, both the lines are intersecting. In this portion, only the green lines can be seen, and in this portion, only black lines are seen. But intersection mean the common. Intersection mean the common area. So here, where both the lines are intersecting, or both the colors, if you are using the color pencils for the shading, so where both the colors are intersecting each other, this area will be the required area. Now, after getting this, that what we have to do, we have to draw the shape again. I am going to draw the shape again to show you the clear answer. So what will be the answer? A and B. This is a required area. This is a required area basically. Are you getting this? Where both the colors are intersecting. First of all, I colored A complement, which was out of A, and then I colored B. Where both the colors are intersecting, so this will be the required area. Now let us have another example. Now the same thing can be done by another way. For that thing, what you have to do, you will have to make three sets. One is the universal set, as I told you that this box is representing the universal set. So if you are not understanding, for example, you get confused in the examination. You got confused in the examination. So what you have to do? In the rough working, you can make a set of your own. For example, you are making the universal set, suppose X, Y, Z and P. These are the elements which you are taking for the universal set. Don't make a longer set. Don't make a very long set with many elements or many members. Just make simple sets. And then you are making a set A. This is just for example. Okay, this is to solve this, that how we are going to find out this area. This will be done in rough. Suppose X, A is having elements X and Y, and there is another set, because here we are discussing two sets other than universal set, Y and Z. Okay, what I am going to do, I am going to mention these elements according to the Venn diagram. A, B, and this is the universal set. All the elements, where X and Y will come? X will come here, okay, and Y will come in the common area. Why? Because Y is the common element of both. And where Z come? Z comes here, and the P will come here. Am I right? Are you getting this? That how I am arranging the elements? So I have arranged the elements according to the sets. Now what should I do? I have to find out A complement first of all. What is A complement? A complement. What are the elements in A complement? Z and P only. Okay. Z and P. Intersection. Now A complement intersection B. What are the common elements here? A complement and this B. Why? Why common? Z. Only the Z common. Z common is it? ठीक है? Only Z is the common in these two sets. In set B, this is YZ. The set A complement is Z and P. So Z is the element which is found in both the sets. So it means the answer of A complement intersection B is Z only. So this area will be shaded. So the same thing I did here. Okay? This is for the sake of convenience. You can make a set like this. Union. Instead of intersection, let us consider the example of union. The set A and set B. The set A and set B. If he says that, show the union of this. So what should I do? Both the circles will be completely shaded. This is the idea of union. That whenever doing the union of two sets, so you will have to shade both the circles. Because union mean you are going to write down all the members of both the sets. It is very simple. Now if it is A union B complement, A union B complement, what should I do? Yes. So complement mean you are not going to shade the area which you have already colored. Out of this area, the complete set will be colored like this. A question like A complement union B complement. A complement union B complement. So with the help of elements, I can solve this. You have already made these two sets. And the universal set, this box is representing the universal set. Then how to color the area? Which one? Other than center, the rest of the circle. Okay, now let us see. A complement, as I told you that A complement is Z and P, and the B complement is X and P. The union of all these, A complement, union, B complement. What are the elements? X, Z and P. X, Z and P is repeating itself. So these three elements, where these three elements are coming? First of all, let me write down X, Y, and this is Z and this is P. So which area? X, Z and P? X, Z and P. Very good. All. Except Y, we have to color all these. If I have A complement intersection B complement, how I am going to? Yes? In this part? Okay. A complement is Z and P, and B complement is Y and Z. Sorry, X and P. X and P are the B complement. Now the union of these two is X, Z and P. So here I wrote the elements that X and Y are the elements of A, Y and Z are the elements of B. P is the element which is lying in the universal set only. Now, which three elements? X, Z and P? X, Z and P. So these are the areas. Now what about this? How we are going to do this? First of all, mention the elements according to their given sets. A complement is also given, B complement is also given. We have to find out the intersection. A complement intersection B complement. Which? A complement and B complement. Which is the common? P? P is the common. So we are going to shade the outer area. This area will be shaded. So here I gave you the example that how you can make a set of your own if you are getting confused related to shading. So you can make a small set, and with the help of that set you can find out that which area can be shaded.